To shed more light on this important report about tourism in Egypt, we are joined over the phone by Dr. Yahya Abdel Qader, tourism expert. Good afternoon and happy Eid to you.
Good afternoon, happy to you.
So the Arab market is one of the most important tourist markets for Egyptian tourism. How do you evaluate the promotional campaigns launched to attract this market?
Well, actually, the Ministry of Tourism has launched an aggressive promotional campaign to attract travel Egypt since last May. And that really dedicated campaign has paid its fruits because hotels in Cairo, Sharm el Sheikh, and Hagara and Alamein has enjoyed over 70% occupancy rates of our visitors to Egypt.
Yes.
And Arab markets represents from 20 to 25% of total arrivals to Egypt. That's nearly over 2 million visitors.
Yes. So how do you read the tourism ministry initiatives of investing the marketing campaigns on social networking sites?
Well, the domestic travel initiative really received support from Egypt Air that operated 200 flights, 250 flights, you know, like at affordable prices for Egyptians and visitors as well. At the same time, Ministry of Tourism Quality Assurance Team, we have checked 120 hotels all over the Egyptian resorts to make sure that they meet international hospitality criteria. And for example, Borsaid Airport was open for the first time since 17 years. So really all this has helped, you know, like to generate the domestic travel initiative.
So earlier, Prime Minister Mustafa Madbouly, the Ministries of Tourism and Antiquities and Civil Aviation launched an initiative to support domestic tourism, which was extended until May 15th. How do you assess that initiative?
Well, really, you know, like we see it's the fruits now, you know, like we had, you know, like occupancy rates at 50%. Now they've been extended to 70%. And in the many resorts on the Mediterranean Sea and the Mediterranean, they now classify for about over 70% occupancy. So that means the initiative has been successful and we get it results. We nearly have like overbooking in many Egyptian resorts and hotels nationwide.
And to what extent activating domestic tours will raise awareness of our great heritage?
Well, you know, of course, you know, like the more you know, like you travel, you appreciate heritage, tolerance, knowledge, understanding, and promote peace. So really, domestic travel initiatives through Prime Minister, Ministry of Tourism, you know, like Antiquities and Ministry of Culture really has been successful as early as 2021.
And, sir, reopening several museums emphasizes the unprecedented support the state gives to tourism and antiquity sector. So what's your take on this?
Well, thank God we are fortunate that Egypt enjoys a diverse selection and collection of museums that reflects its historical authenticity, originality, from archaeological to culture to art to agriculture and craft. And they attract, you know, like both local and world visitors as well.
So, Dr. Abdel Qader, also reopening several museums emphasizes the unprecedented support the state gives to tourism and antiquity sector in general, as we have just said. So, how do you see preparations for the inauguration of the Grand Egyptian Museum?
Well, the Grand Egyptian Museum really is like an epic event, you know, like, for example, our ambassador in Ottawa, in Canada. Like this week, you know, like he made a presentation about the process, you know, like, and the preliminary steps for the opening of the Grand Egyptian Museum. And the media worldwide, you know, like they are eager, you know, like to write stories about its sophisticated collections and preparation for this. So this is one of the grandiose events after, you know, like the parade of the Golden Mummies from the Cairo Museum to the Fustat Museum civilization. So this is an epic event really for the century.
So, sir, at the past, the schools used to organize trips to archaeological sites in Egypt. Do you think that we should organize more such trips again?
Well, definitely, yes. You know, like we have now, like, mashallah, like a grand number of the students, like from kindergarten up to, you know, like colleges and secondary schools. So, but I observed that many tour guides, they accompany and escort schools on their, you know, like weekly tours, that they conduct regular tours to like pyramids, Saqqara, tourist sites, culture and archaeological museum. I've been last week to the Museum of Ustat Civilization on a daily basis. They receive around 7,000 to 8,000 New York visitors, large number of them students, you know, like from different age brackets. So really, Egyptians now are eager, you know, like to visit museums and appreciate their heritage. Yeah.
Also, there are some calls to include museums in school curriculums. How do you read these calls?
Well, really, this is very essential because children at age of 6 worldwide, you know, like the, as I've been like working for Mr. Tourism and Promotion, I have visited the schools and they study Egyptian, you know, like history, archaeology, they write hieroglyphic letters. So really, I look forward that the Ministers of Education, we look forward that they include culture tourism to the curriculum of schools and colleges on a nationwide scale. This is a very positive, you know, like idea, and I like it to be taught like in Arabic, in English, and if it's possible, in a third language as well. Yes.
Sir, also, how can we invest in the archaeological discoveries in Egypt, as we can see that we have a new discovery every day, and we need to promote for these discoveries?
Well, actually, you know, like we are fortunate, you know, like with our heritage and background, which is recognized worldwide, and there are international museums that display, you know, like Egyptian collections, limited ones. So each time we have like an opening discovery, as we've been witnessing for the past years, so that gather, you know, like world media awareness, digital, you know, like networking, and we have like photographers, documentaries, bloggers who like to come to Egypt, you know, like, and shoot these events and display it. Because with every discovery, there's new findings and description and interpretation of the eras, because everything about Egyptian civilization hasn't been discovered.
And how far from your perspective can we attract new markets and open new gates for the markets we are already dealing with?
Well, for the time being, we're doing well, but really to attract, you know, like fresh and new markets and, you know, like new entries, nearly that depends on offering quality services. So this is one of the areas, you know, like we have to work hard, because visitors, you know, like they like to enjoy during their traveling experience, you know, like going to libraries, museums, entertainment, musical theaters. They try to the gastronomy tourism. They do shopping as well, you know, like to try to local and traditional artifacts, you know, like. So really, we have to develop this more. For example, we have it specifically like in Aswan, where they go and buy the spices and, you know, like the artifacts and the textile, you know, from Aswan. So we need to develop this on a nationwide basis to have exclusive markets that displays the arts and crafts of the region. That's even like food, you know, like. So that's why travelers like to do when they travel. We need to do this.
So, Dr. Abdelkader, boosting tourism has turned to be one of the essential goals of the government. Would you please highlight to us the latest cooperation between the different ministries to achieve this goal?
Well, really, you know, like we have like over 32 ministries, and you know, like there's one major target for them is to assist and support, you know, like the tourism development to Egypt, and we do this like in education. Minister of Education, you know, like on higher education, they have schools for hotels and tour guidance and tourism management as well. Ministry of Culture, they develop like events, you know, like Opera Aida and other, you know, like events as well. For example, Dr. Abdanchi is in Rome now, and the Egyptian opera is displaying Aida in Rome. You know, like this is another cooperation between Egypt and Rome. Hmm. We had last month at the St. Petersburg Opera and dance group performing at the Egyptian ballet, you know, like in Russia. So exchange of culture with the support of Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of Foreign Affairs that conduct events even in the foreign capitals. So the whole ministries and Dr. Makram of the Ministry of Immigration as well, all of them, they support and cooperate, coordinate events to highlight the achievements that we're doing in Egypt, you know, like in Kalala, in Sokhna, the administrative capital, and the New Alamein, which is the president is currently visiting and meeting high-rank officials.
So, sir, as we are celebrating Eid, what are the most attractive destinations for tourists in Eid vacation?
Well, Cairo, of course, is a classical hub, you know, like for Arab travelers that they have been, you know, like hundreds of years, you know, like coming to spend their vacations in Egypt, you know, like meet their friends, have some entertainment and shopping, and attend like the book fair, which is was very successful, ended last week. And some of them, they like to go to the Red Sea, and the rest will be going to New Alamein. And you know about large groups of our and GCC visitors that you go to New Alamein to enjoy it, you know, like exotic, you know, like beaches and resorts and such.
So, sir, one final question. Egypt has participated recently in an international summit on the recovery of tourism, and it was held in Kenyan capital, Nairobi. The summit sheds light on the rediscovery of new ways to build the African tourism sector, which has been hit hard by coronavirus. So how do you see the importance of this summit, and how can we develop intra-African tourism?
Well, Mr. Ahmed Youssef, chairman of the Egyptian Tourism Authority, you know, like he attended that meeting. And Egypt is an active member of the African Travel Association. And he requested that, you know, like Egypt with the other number of, you know, like associated companies in the North Africa and Sub-Sahara, they work, you know, like collectively to develop, you know, like travel programs and make cooperation and to make it accessible to visitors and encourage young people and businessmen to develop projects, for example, like in Kenya and Tanzania and Senegal. And we have Egyptian businessmen who have hotels and hospitality projects in these regions as well.
Also, if we talk about the performance of the tourism sector as we're approaching now the mid of 2021, how do you see the performance till now?
Well, really, so far we've been faring so well. You remember we had the Secretary General of the World Tourism Organization, Mr. Kashvel, he came to Egypt twice. We had the President of the UNESCO who came to Egypt twice. And they highly commended the performance of the government and the Ministry of Tourism and Antiquities because, you know, like we followed the criteria of the World Health Organization and the IATA. And everything, all the organization associated with processing and organizing tourism, especially at the hard times of the pandemic we've been going through. So the Ministry of Tourism has checked all the hotels and made sure that the staff has been vaccinated and it is safe. That's why we've been receiving visitors from 35 countries, from Ukraine, from Russia, from Serbia, from Switzerland, from Vienna, from Germany, apart from the GCC countries as well. So we did our homework. That's why we're having a good season this year, inshallah.
So finally, I'd like to thank you, Dr. Yahya Abdelkader, tourism expert, and happy Eid to you.